Hello students, welcome back. In the last lesson, we studied about monohybrid cross, which was experimented by Mendel. What he did in that, he took a pea plant with one of the characteristic features and then crossed them with each other. That was called as monohybrid cross. Mono means one. So he had taken only one characteristic feature. Now we are going to see what Mendel did. What he found out when he undergone or when he did a dihybrid cross. Dihybrid cross means what? Di means two. That means he took two pea plants with having various different characteristic features. He took the seed shape and the seed color. Two contrasting color characteristics he thought of. He said that he will take two different characteristics of the pea plant. So he took seed shape and seed color. So two things he took, seed shape and seed color. So two pea plants he took. In one pea plant he saw that it has the characteristics of round and yellow seed. That means it had the seeds which were round and which were yellow in color. And in the other pea plant, he took the round, not the round one, but the wrinkled one, which is not smooth. It is wrinkled. That means the shape was wrinkled. And which color he took? Instead of yellow, he considered the green seeds. So two things he took, two contrasting colors. Now, in the color part, he took yellow and green. And green colored seeds. This is for color. And for shape he took round and wrinkled. So two contrasting characters he thought of. He found out the two pea plants and these two characteristic features he tried to cross over. That's why it is called as dihybrid cross. Now when he took one plant with yellow and red round. So round seed and color is yellow. So he said one will be dominant, one will be recessive. So in one pea plant, he had round seeds and yellow colored seeds. In other pea plant, he had wrinkled seeds and green seeds. So wrinkled means which were not smooth and the color it took was green seeds. So when he took two characteristics of two different plants and they tried to cross over, what did he find out? This type of cross is called as Mendel's dihybrid cross. Now, if I say one parent had round seed plus yellow color seed, and other parent Now the other parent has wrinkled seed plus green seed. These are the characteristic features he took in the pea plant. And so one parent will have round seed and yellow seed, and these were found to be dominant characters. So he gave the letters for round seeds as RR. That means capital R, capital R. Two genes will come out from the round seed. This is characteristic features which we consider. And for yellow seed, which is dominant, it is capital Y, capital Y. So this is what was in the first parent. That means the genetic character of the one parent pea plant, it had two R's capital, two Y's capital. These are dominant. So that is why we have used the letter capital letters. So these are the dominant characters which might come in the first generation, that is a filial generation. And the other plant, wrinkled seeds, now in one for round we have used capital R, for wrinkled we will use small r. So two small r's for wrinkled. For yellow we have used capital Y, so for green seed we want to show it recessive character, we will show it with small r. So these are the two parent which carries RR and YY genes, and here small r RR and small YY genes. One parent this characteristic features, other parent this characteristic features. Now when they cross over, what will happen? Now this pea plant will show two types of characteristic features, one with red and one with yellow. So how it will be showing? It will be shown like this, one R capital Y, one R capital Y. Because one gene will show one characteristic features, so one R and one Y, one R and one Y. And here it will be shown like this, one small RY, one small RY. These are the two characteristic features which are going to cross over, and we have to see what will be the first generation result. Now when one first generation result happens, we are going to see that all the plants which will be obtained will have dominant characters, though the genetic matter transferred will be recessive also. Now how we will show that? We will show with the help of the table which we did in monohybrid cross. Let's show it. So we'll show parent generation, P1 generation. Now as I said, parent generation, one parent will have capital RR and YY, the other parent will have small RR and small YY. So we will show first capital R, capital R, capital Y, and small R, small R, small Y, small Y. These are the two parents where the crossing is going to take place. These two parents have two contrasting features. One is round seeds and other one having the wrinkled seeds. One is having the yellow color seeds, one is having the green color seeds. So we are using same letters, but only dominant will show the capital letter, recessive will show the small letter. Now what are the gametes which comes out? Gametes mean the cell, or the sex cell which is coming out. It is RY and RY. So we can say these are gametes. And this is P1 generation. P stands for parent generation. Here it is small RY and small RY. These are the gametes which are going to cross over. Now as I said in the last time, this will cross over with both of these. This will also cross over with both of this. So let's draw with the help of arrows this one and this one. So data RY RY. So I can write like this. I am getting such type of result. One capital R, one small R, one capital Y, one small Y. So this is how you have to write for this R. Now this RY also combines with this small RY. So again same result. Capital R, small R, capital Y, small Y. Okay, now this one gamete has combined with these two gametes in this way. The other gamete, now this will combine with this small RY and will get the same result like this. And this one with this one. This is called as F1 generation. F stands for filial generation. So it is also called as filial 1 generation. Now what do we see in this generation? Phenotypically means physically, what we are seeing? We are seeing only the dominant characters, though crossing over has recessive characters also in the F1 generation. But here you can see capital R is also there, capital Y is also there. So this will look wise, this will be round and yellow. That means the plants which are coming in the first generation will show round and yellow seeds. Here also we have two dominant characters. So this is also round and yellow seeds. This is also round and yellow seeds, and here also dominant is there, so round and yellow seeds. So what is the result of F1 generation? F1 generation will show all the plants getting the dominant characters which can be seen. That means phenotypically it will be round and yellow seeds in all the F1 generation pea plants. This is the result of F1 generation. Now in the F1 generation, what has happened? We have got capital R, capital Y also. We have got small r, small y also. That means the original parental combination is also there and recombination is also there. So I can say that r, y and small r, y, which we have got in F1 generations, is also called as parental combination. That means what parent had, they also had. Then what is the recombination? If I say recombination, can be small r capital Y and capital R small y. This is called as recombination. So these are the different types of combinations we have found after crossover. So when you get the answer, you will say that F1 generation phenotypically look wise all are round and yellow seeds. But if I go through the gametes which have come in the first generation, we can say capital R, Y, capital Y, small r, small y, they are the parent combination because one parent had this. But what is the new combination which has formed? Small r, capital Y, capital R, small y. This is the new combination which has formed, so it is called as recombination. So if you can be asked one more question. In F1 generation, in dihybrid cross, which are the parental combination and which are the recombination? So it's very easy to understand. In parents, whichever are there, you can say capital R, capital Y, it is there. Yes, here it is there. So you can say they are the parental combination. New type of combination, this small r and big Y, is it here in the parents? No. That means it has been formed after new combination. So that is called as recombination. Now the second step. Mendel saw that the first generation look wise they were all same. That means they all had round and yellow seeds. Now if I take these two pea plants as parents, then what will happen in the F2 generation? Now this F2 generation will be a big one. We can show in a square type structure which is called as Punnett square. And another name is checkerboard. So I'll just show you how it is made in the second generation. In the F2 generation, we will take the parents which have come in the F1 generation. The parents which were come were round and yellow seeds. So those were the dominant seeds. That means these two parents, if I take from F1 generation, these are the parents capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. These are the gametes coming from the first generation. Now, when these two parents are crossed, what will happen? We are getting four type of gametes, right? So small r, small y, capital R, capital Y. These are the parental combinations. These are the new combinations. Small r, capital Y, capital R, small y. So these are called as, these are parental combinations. And these are recombination. So when these are crossed, that means one will be the male, one will be the female. So when it is crossed, we can arrange in a table form that is called as Punnett square or the checkerboard diagram. This is a very important diagram to make you understand how you can do it. Instead of drawing lines and arrows, it becomes very confusing in the F2 generation. So this type of square we have drawn. Here the horizontally I am showing all the types of gametes which are male. This sign is for male, one circle and one arrow up. This is for male. And the gametes which are showing female gametes, these are showing the circle and plus sign down. These are the female, these are the male. These are the male gametes, these are the female gametes. Now they are crossing over each other. I have written in red the name, number of the square. So if I say in square number 4, what is the result? We can easily find out. Or in which square the pure form of dominant characters can be seen? In which square the recessive characters purely can be seen? So it's very easy to find out from this square. Now let's start how to do it. Now this small ri, small ry, this small ry. If I cross it, you will find it. You are right, getting small ry, small ry. Got it? So when we write small ry, generally by writing we'll show both the r's together and both y's together. I don't want to explain it, but while writing, we will write all r's together and all y's together so that it is easy to understand which is dominant, which is not dominant. So small r, ry, small yy. This is the first result. Now ry small and capital ry. What will be the result? So I will write capital R first, small r second, capital Y third, and small y fourth. This is the way to represent in the square. It becomes very easy. You can see in the first box, we got all the recessive characters. Small rr, small yy. That means they are not round, they are wrinkled. They are not yellow, they are green. So wrinkled and green, recessive characters are found in the first block when these two get crossed over. Second block, what we see round and yellow dominance. So when we get the seed, we'll see it is round and it is yellow. But genotypically, is it same? Genetically, it is not same because it has got round and it has got wrinkled also, small r also. So this is the way we can easily understand from this square. Third one, r, small y, capital Y. So I will write 2r small, correct, these 2r's, and capital Y and small y. Now what is dominant here? Here the yellow color is dominant. But along with yellow color, what will be seen? The wrinkled seed will be seen. Because recessive character have come up, there is no other dominant character. Now third, fourth square, small ry, capital R, small y. So capital R generally we write first, then the small r. Now both y's are small, so I will write it both small y's. This is the result of the fourth square. Now come to the second part. This is the next gamete. This gamete remains same. We have to combine it one by one. Ry, ry. So what will I write? Capital R from here, small r from here. Capital Y from here, small y from here. This is round and yellow, which are dominant. So phenotypically, physically, look wise, you will see it is round and yellow. But genotypically, it is combination of both dominant and recessive. Second one, both are capitals. So I show R, R, Y, Y. From R from here, R from here, Y from here, Y from here. All capitals. That means in square number 6, we get all dominant characters only, purely dominant characters. Then here, square number 7, capital R, small r, capital Y, capital Y. Now here, 3 things are dominant. That means R round is dominant and yellow color is dominant. But only the wrinkled is recessive character. Square number 8. RY, RY, both R's capital. Now capital Y is here and small y is here. We have to combine like this and it's very easy to write down. This is square number 8. What about square number 9? This R small, capital Y, so small y. So I'll write first 2 R's which are both small, 1 Y capital, 1 Y small. Second one, small r, capital Y, capital R, capital R, Y. So R and R, capital Y, capital Y. These two crosses, we get this result. Square number 11, small r, capital Y. Very easy, 2R small and 2Y big. That means here, the recessive character is seen because round seeds are not seen. Here the wrinkled seeds are seen and yellow color is seen because both are dominant. 12th square, R from here, this small r from here, capital Y from here and small y from here. This is the 12th square which will come. Now the 13th square, capital R from here, small r from here, both the y's are small. That means round color will be seen, but round wrinkled color, wrinkled shape will not be seen. Yellow color will not be seen because both are recessive. So green color will be seen here. In the 14th square, R and R, because both R's are capital, one capital Y, one small y. 15th square, R big from here, small r from here, capital Y from here, small y from here. And 16th square, R capital, 2y small. This is the result of F2 generation when these two parents from F1 generation are crossed. These two parents gave four type of gametes in male and female, two which were the parental combinations and two which are the recombinations, and we got this square showing the result. Now based on this, there is a table in your book on page number 166. Just go through the page number 166 and I can explain you. There's a table given. The ratio which has come is 9:3:3:1. Now how 9:3:3:1 has come? First ratio has come as 9:3:3:1. This is phenotypic ratio. How phenotypic? Look wise, physically, what we are seeing? We are seeing the ratio of 9:3:3:1. Now what is 9? 9 is round and yellow. 9 is round and yellow. That means the dominant characters. In which squares we are seeing that? There are 9 squares where we are seeing capital R and capital Y. We can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So many squares have round and yellow. That means this is the dominant characters, round and yellow. So 9 ratio is nothing but round and yellow where all we can see. Second, wrinkled and yellow, that is 3. Wrinkled and yellow. That means I am telling it is only 3 boxes. Now let me see. Wrinkled means small r and yellow means capital R. So here small r and capital Y, that means here I can see 1. Then small r's and capital Y, this is the another one, 9th one, and small r and capital Y in the 11th one. Otherwise we don't see round and wrinkled and yellow. Wrinkled and yellow we are seeing in 3 boxes. Round and yellow we are seeing in 9 boxes. What is the third? This 3. Now this 3 is round and green. Round and green. Round means I want to see the capital R, and green means I want to see the small y. So capital R and small y. Capital R and small y. One case, then capital R and small y, second case, and capital R and small y, third case. So this is 3, round and green. 9:3:3. Now what is 1 left? It is wrinkled and green. Wrinkled and green means wrinkled, that means small r, green means small y. In which case all are small? Only in one case all are small. So that 1% becomes here. So what is the ratio phenotypically in F2 generation? It is 9:3:3:1. 9 boxes will have round and yellow. That means 9 pea plants will be showing phenotypically round seeds and yellow seeds. 3 plants, 3 boxes here, 3 plants will be showing wrinkled and yellow seeds. That means the wrinkled will be dominant round and yellow seeds are dominant. Third, three boxes or three plants will show round and green. That means the round and green. Round is dominant, was dominant, and green was recessive, but now green has become dominant. And what is one? One is wrinkled and green, where both were recessive and it has become, now we can see actually in a plant both the recessive characters as dominant. So the ratio of F2 generation is 9:3:3:1. This is F2 generation. Very important to understand how to make it. I have shown you just crosses. These are the gametes, male gametes. These are the female gametes. So I can just shade this so that you can understand this better. These are the gametes. These boxes are not showing the result, these boxes are showing the gametes. So these boxes are showing the gametes. This is the female gamete, this is the male gamete. This can be said as male gamete and this is a female gamete. So this is how the Punnett square becomes very easy for us to understand. If we draw like this and just put the number to the boxes, and here the F2 generation comes out to be 9:3:3:1. How it came, I have shown you. Where was the number box, how many boxes were there for 9? There were around 9 boxes out of 16. 3 boxes out of 16 were for wrinkled and yellow. 3 boxes were for round and green. And one box was for wrinkled and green. This is the ratio. How it, this is very important. It comes for 3 to 4 marks question, and you can be asked in any other character also. Any other tallness, dwarfness also can be given. Color can be given. The color of the axial position of the flower can be given. Anything. So if you are making a dominant character capital, same letter in small you have to use. You cannot use round and wrinkled. So round for R and wrinkle for W. No, you cannot use. You should use only one letter which can be made into capital for dominant and small for recessive. This is activity 13.4 in your book on page number 167. Please open it. It's very important. You have to fill up using this box. Now there are two columns given. One is phenotype, one is genotype. You can open the book, you can fill it with your pencil. Round and yellow, that means round and yellow. How many, what are the square numbers of round and yellow? We can write here. How many number of boxes can be seen? Number of squares. There should be 9. So what are the number of boxes or the squares which are showing the round and yellow? You can say it is 2, 5, 6, 7. 2, 5, 6, 7. Then 8, 10, 12. 8, 10, 12. 14 and 15. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. These are the boxes which are showing round and yellow. So there is a column in your book which you have to fill the numbers, square numbers. The square numbers are 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10, 12, 14, 15. Second is wrinkled and yellow. This is only 3 boxes, as we can see 9:3:3:1. So wrinkled and yellow, it is 3, 9 and 11. This is 3 wrinkled and yellow, 9 wrinkled and yellow and 11 wrinkled and yellow. This is the second box. Round and green. How many boxes of round and green? As I said here, again 3 boxes of round and green. they are 4, 13, 16. These are the 3 boxes for round and green. Wrinkled and green. Fourth one. This is the first box which are showing wrinkled and green. This is the number of boxes, number of squares. The square number I have written. Here the square numbers are written in red, which you can easily identify. This is all phenotype. A phenotype means physically when the plants are growing in the F2 generation, physically what color seeds I am seeing. So I am seeing the seeds in this ratio of 9:3:3:1, 9 for round and yellow, 3 for wrinkled and yellow, next 3 for round and green, and 1 for wrinkled and green. This is the first column of activity 13.4 which you have to fill up here. Now, second column, genotype. Now, what is genotype? Genetically, which dominant or which recessive character is seen genetically in the result? So, that we will see now. First is RRYY, both capitals. Now, which is that? It is square number 6. So, you can write in the box square number 6 for RRYY. Just find out where it is. It's very easy to find from here and the table. Second one, R capital small r, Y capital small y. Now, where you are going to see this? In the second one, R capital small r, Y capital Y small. Then here, fifth one, then here, 12th one, and 15th one. So, here you are going to see two, second one, fifth one, then 12th one and 15th one. You can easily find out. Capital R's 2 and 2 small y's. You are going to find them in 16th column. So the square number is 16 for RR capital small y in the 16th square. This is how you can complete the table of the genotype. Just look at this table, which square checker box we have made, and find out the genes or the genotype which is shown here. It's very easy. I don't have to write also, because you can just find out which square number has which type of genotype. So what is the genotype ratio now? The genotype ratio will be is 1:1:2:2:2:4:2:2:1:1. You can just find out it that is coming 16 1 2 3 4 5 6. You add this genotype. I have written 1:1, that means 1 is for RRYY capital. Then this, like this, the way they have given us, we have to find the ratio. So 1:1:2:2:4:2:2:1:1. So the type of genotype which is given in your activity, these are these. If you add, it comes to 16. That means 16 types of plants are formed with having different varieties of dominant and recessive. 1+1, 2+2, 4+2, 6, 10, 12, 16, 14 and 16. So these are 16 squares or 16 plants which you can identify by genotypic ratio. This is phenotypic ratio, that is 9:3:3:1. Genotypic ratio is 1:1:2:2:4:2:2:1:1. This is what is the answer for first question under the box. Which squares show pure dominant and pure recessive traits? This is the second question given in the activity. Now, pure dominant. Pure dominant is square number 6. Capital R, capital R, capital Y, capital Y. So, square number 6 has pure dominant traits or genes. And pure recessive traits. Square number one, both small r, both small y's. So this is the result, or this is the answer for the second question. I hope you have understood both the levels, that means the F1 generation, F2 generation, when we consider dihybrid cross. In the F2 generation, this square, if you are able to do, very easy to understand further. What you have to remember? Basically, you have to remember which are the two parents, what are the gametes they are giving. Gametes will be same for male and female. Only we are showing that these are the males, these are the females, and they are crossing each other. So when they cross over each other, 16 types of plants are formed. 16 types of plants with different dominant and recessive characters. So this, you don't have to learn also. By combination, by logical thinking, you can just write down and answer the questions. There is a box given in the where the questions are given on page 167. First question, what do you mean by DNA? It's very easy. Full form of DNA you have to write. DNA is deoxyribonucleic acid. This DNA is present in genes which are present in the chromosomes. So chromosomes contains genes which contains DNA or deoxyribonucleic acid. Now this DNA is passed on from the parents to the offspring, and that is why this DNA carries the genetic character which can be identified in a offspring also, and some characters can be easily seen from parents to offspring. Second question, what is the peculiarity of this structure? This structure is double helix. That means it has two types of spiral binds which are held together by some proteins. And this double helix structure, they contain deoxyribose sugar, they contain phosphoric acid, and they contain nitrogenous bases such as guanine, adenine, thymine, and cytosine. So these are the four types of base or nitrogenous base which are holding the two spiral things which are present in the DNA structure. And this nucleotide structure in the DNA molecule is called gene. When I say the spiral structure is present, that spiral structure are held together by this nitrogenous bases which are adenine, guanine, cytosine, and thymine. You can see the figure on page number 168. On the 168 page, you can see the spiral. It looks like a ladder. And ladder, the way it is spirally bounded, there is actually, those are the pieces of genes which are connected to each other through the nitrogenous bases. This is the structure of DNA. Third question here. Name the scientist who put forward the most popular model of DNA. So there are two scientists who got the Nobel Prize also for that. James Watson. Watson is the name. James Watson and Francis Crick. Francis Crick and James Watson in 1953. They proposed this model of DNA, and for that they got a Nobel Prize in 1962. So these are the two scientists who first found out what might be the structure of DNA, and this DNA was found by, or structure was given by, proposed by James Watson and Francis Crick.